Hi students, all of you, welcome to my class. In today's session, we are going to discuss elimination versus substitution reactions in haloalkanes. Once again, I am going to recall what is an elimination reaction, what is a substitution reaction. So wait for 5 minutes, otherwise skip the same video up to 5 minutes. Right, so first of all I am going to say about elimination reaction. Elimination reaction, in the first PUC in the organic chemistry you studied dehydrohalogenation reaction. Dehydrohalogenation reaction. The dehydrohalogenation reaction is an example of elimination reaction. Already you studied in the first PUC. I am writing the example. To undergo dehydrohalogenation, I am taking the example ethyl bromide. Ethyl bromide is written as CH2 single bond H. That is CH3 single bond CH2 single bond Br. Ethyl bromide, it is the common name, right? When it is going to react with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, that gives, of course, it comes under a second PUC also because it is a alkyl halide. Alkyl halides are nothing but haloalkanes. So this reaction is both in first PUC as well as coming under second PUC also. And here we are going to say that it is a dehydrohalogenation reaction. D means removal. Hydrogen is going to be removed. Halogen is going to be removed. So when hydrogen and halogen both are going to be removed, that is called as dehydrohalogenation reaction. Okay, this is the halogen bonded carbon. This carbon is known as alpha carbon. Its adjacent carbon is known as beta carbon. So now removal of hydrogen is going to take place from beta carbon. Hence, this reaction is called as beta elimination reaction. Halogen is going to be eliminated from alpha carbon. When it is happening, when the alkyl halide, that is the ethyl bromide, is heated with alcoholic potassium hydroxide. Here we know potassium hydroxide is a strong base. Once again, potassium hydroxide is a strong base. Remember this one, already you know that one. Potassium hydroxide is a strong base. What is the nature of base? According to Lewis theory, a base means proton acceptor. Once again, a base means proton acceptor. Here OH minus ions are there. These OH minus ions are going to accept a proton from beta carbon. So this beta carbon containing hydrogens, one of the hydrogen is going to be attracted by or accepted by OH minus ion, removed as water molecule. So here, what is going to be eliminated? Hydrogen is going to be eliminated as H plus ion. As a result, this bond is going to be migrated between alpha and beta carbon. Then single bond becomes double bond. As a result, this bromine is going to be removed or eliminated as Br minus ion. Including the bond, bromine is removed, written as Br minus. Excluding the bond, hydrogen is removed, that is written as H plus. So finally, in this compound, that is ethyl bromide, hydrogen is removed from beta carbon, halogen is removed from alpha carbon. So according to the removal of hydrogen, which is removed from beta carbon, this elimination is called as Particularly, this elimination is called as beta elimination reaction. Dehydrohalogenation reactions are the examples of beta elimination reaction, right? When this bond is going to be migrated between carbon and carbon, then what we can write? CH2 single bond becomes double bond. That is a CH2 double bond CH2 known as ethene. Two carbons are here. Two carbons. Eth. Double bond is called as ethene. And this hydrogen, which is removed as H+, react with OH- forms water molecule, right? Plus the bromine, which is removed as Br- reacts with potassium ions, K+ ions, forms KBr, potassium bromide. Already in the first PUC, you studied the same reaction, which is known as dehydrohalogenation reaction, and it is an example of beta elimination reaction. Why we are saying beta elimination? Because hydrogen is going to be eliminated from beta carbon. Hence, this elimination is called as beta elimination reaction. Very important one. Remember this one. Beta elimination, dehydrohalogenation is an example of beta elimination reaction, right? According to our second PUC, we are comparing elimination reaction versus substitution reaction in haloalkanes. It is a haloalkane. Whether here substitution is happening or elimination is happening, you will get a doubt. Sir, already it is elimination. How can we say substitution means? Very simple. Instead of removal of bromide, that means if the bromide is removed and OH is substituted, then what we can write? CH3 is same. Suppose, of course, it does not occur. Just I am expressing to you, CH3, single bond, CH2, and bromine is substituted, suppose, with OH, we will get CH3, CH2, OH. It is known as ethyl alcohol. So when CH3, CH2Br, that is ethyl bromide, reacting with alcoholic potassium hydride, what is going to happen? Elimination is going to happen, but not substitution is going to happen. So elimination reactions are taking place in presence of strong base. Once again, the elimination reactions are taking place in the presence of strong base. Then you can understand easily. So elimination reactions can occur in the presence of a strong base. What is meant by a strong base? According to Lewis acid base theory, which is going to readily accept a proton, that is called as a strong base. Here, alcoholic potassium hydroxide is acting as a strong base, and the potassium hydroxide containing OH- ions are going to accept a proton from the beta carbon. Hence, beta carbon is going to lose hydrogen as H+ ion. Alpha carbon is going to lose halogen as halide ion. Hence, elimination reaction is favorable. So, in the case of haloalkanes, when the elimination reactions are favorable, when the haloalkanes are treated or reacted with strong bases, then haloalkanes are readily undergoing elimination reactions, right? When the substitution reactions take place. Now we'll get it out. Sir, when we will get the substitution reaction? Substitution reactions, which type of substitution happens? Which type of substitution haloalkanes undergoes? You know that in the previous videos we discussed, in the haloalkanes, they undergoing nucleophilic substitution reactions. Once again, haloalkanes are undergoing nucleophilic substitution reactions. So here you can see the word. What is this word? Nucleophile. So to undergo the substitution reactions, what is required? A nucleophile is required. So substitution reactions are favorable in presence of or by reacting with a nucleophile. And elimination reactions are favorable when haloalkanes are going to react with strong base, When haloalkanes are going to react with a strong base, elimination reactions are favorable. When haloalkanes are reacting with the nucleophiles, strong nucleophiles or strong attacking nucleophiles, then substitution reactions are favorable. So this is the general interaction to compare elimination versus substitution, right? Now we are going to see a reaction. I am going to consider here second degree alkyl halides, because you know that first degree alkyl halides, they are undergoing inversion of configuration. That means nucleophile is going to be substituted or attacked from the backside. So first degree alkyl halides, they are readily undergoing nucleophilic substitution reaction. Of course, you will get it out again. Sir, this is also first degree alkyl halide. But when we are taking the strong base, then elimination takes place. Suppose if we take a nucleophile, then nucleophilic substitution reactions are going to take place. Right, we are going to explain with examples. Here I am taking a second degree alkyl halide. Second degree alkyl halide, that is a C single bond H, right? Single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond Br. Carbon single bond halogen. This is a haloalkane, and the halogen bonded carbon bonded to one carbon and second carbon. Halogen bonded carbon bonded to two carbons. Hence, this carbon is known as second degree carbon. Hence, this is an example of second degree alkyl halide. When it is going to react with a strong base, what is meant by strong base? Which can easily accept a proton. Right, I am going to take a strong base, that is a CH3, single bond C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond O, oxygen with three lone pairs of electrons with negative charge. Of course, you know that if any species which is going to have excess pair of electrons and that is able to donate the pair of electrons, that act as a nucleophile. Here, of course, oxygen containing electron pair, that one of the pair can be donated towards hydrogen. That means it is acting as a nucleophile. But here, this is of course a nucleophile, but it is a strong nucleophile. That means here, this methyl group is going to shift its bonded electrons towards carbon. Methyl group is going to shift its bonded electrons towards carbon. Methyl group is going to shift its bonded electrons towards carbon. That means methyl groups are acting as electron donating groups. As a result, on the oxygen, electron density increases. When the electron density increases, it is ready to accept a proton. Hence, it is acting as CH3, single bond C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond O minus. It is acting as a strong base. So whenever the strong base is there, the strong base is going to accept a proton. As a result, this bond is going to be shifted or migrated between carbon and carbon. This bond is going to be removed. This bond is going to be removed. Then what you can write? CH3 single bond CH3 single bond O bonding with hydrogen. That means in this reaction, what is going to be removed? CH3 taken thrice, 1, 2, 3. That is CH3 taken thrice, OH. This is going to be removed because oxygen is going to be bonded with hydrogen. Hence, I am writing here alcohol, that is tertiary butyl alcohol is removed. And here, bromine is going to be removed. Bromine is removed as Br minus, right? Finally, between the carbon and carbon, single bond becomes double bond. Now I can write CH2 double bond CH, CH2, double bond CH, CH2, single bond becomes double bond CH, single bond CH3, single bond CH3. So here, what you are observing? In the product, unsaturation is obtained. In the product, when the unsaturation is obtained during a reaction, the reaction is known as elimination reaction. So this reaction is an example of elimination reaction. So whenever an alkyl halide is going to react with a strong base, then the reaction is known as elimination reaction, and the products are going to be unsaturated products. That is about elimination reactions in haloalkanes. So haloalkanes are undergoing elimination reactions in presence of strong base. So which type of compounds or which type of species are acting as strong base? To act as strong base, the species must contain more number of electron donating groups, or simply I can say that it is a bulky group, it is a bulky group, it is a bulky group. So when the bulky groups are there, more number of bulky groups are there, and they are acting as electron donating groups, that is going to act as a strong base. When such strong bases are going to react with alkyl halides, the reaction is going to give an elimination product, right? Next we are going to see substitution. Which type of substitution? Nucleophilic substitution reactions in haloalkanes. So to undergo nucleophilic substitution reactions, haloalkanes must react with a nucleophile. Not it is a strong base, it is a weak base, nothing but just it is going to act as a nucleophile. Now I am asking you a question. What is meant by a nucleophile? Nucleus loving species. Once again, what is meant by nucleophile? Nucleus loving species is called as nucleophile. Nucleus means, what is meant by nucleus? Nothing but positively charged center. Of course, in the atom, the center of the atom is called as nucleophile, and the center of the atom contain protons and neutrons. So the center of the atom is going to contain positive charge. So in general, positively charged center, that is the nucleophile, right? So now it is a substitution reactions. Substitution reactions of haloalkanes. Already in the starting videos, we discussed so many number of substitution reactions. Right here, what is the criteria to undergo substitution reaction for haloalkanes? What is the criteria? Already I said that a nucleophile is required. Nucleophile means that must attack on electrophilic center. Once again, nucleophile means that must attack on electrophilic center. Electrophilic center means electron deficient center. Right, see the reaction. Once again, we are taking the same second degree alkyl halide, that is a C, single bond H, single bond CH3. I am not expanding CH3. Here again, CH3, single bond Br. The same reactant, in the previous reaction also, the same reactant is taken, and it is an example of second degree alkyl. It is an example of second degree alkyl halide. Now it is going to react with a nucleophile. Here I am taking the nucleophile is ethoxide ion. What is ethoxide ion? What is the formula of ethoxide ion? Ethoxide ion, the formula is written as C2H5O minus, that is expanded as CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond O, oxygen with three lone pairs of electrons with negative charge. My dear students, in the previous reaction also we considered an alkoxide ion, but in the previous reaction the alkoxide ion is containing three alkyl groups. Now see here, this is the ethoxide ion, again it is also alkoxide ion, but here oxygen is going to contain how many alkyl groups? Tell me. whether it is one or two. Oxygen is going to contain only one alkyl group. What is that alkyl group? See here, this is oxygen. What is alkyl group? Ethyl group. So whenever a space is with lone pairs of electrons are there, or with negative charges there, with less number of electron donating groups, that is going to act as a nucleophile only, right? What is meant by nucleophile means, here it is a secondary degree alkyl halide. Halogen contain partial negative charge, carbon contain partial positive charge. You know that any center with partial positive charge is called as electrophilic center. Once again, any center with partial positive charge is called as electrophilic center. Now it is a nucleophile. This nucleophile is going to attack on the electrophilic center from the back side of the carbon. Why? Because means front side is negative charge is there. If the negative charge attacks from the front side, repulsion will arise. As a result, in this reaction, the nucleophile, that is the ethoxide ion, is going to attack from the back side of the carbon. As a result, this halogen is going to be removed from the front side. So when the back side attacking is going to happen, front side bonds are going to be leaved. What you will expect, that is the transition state. So in this reaction, first we can see a transition state. I can write the transition state as C. This is the C, single bond H. This is a hydrogen. And two methyl groups are there. I'm writing the two methyl groups as CH3, single bond CH3, right? CH, CH3, CH3. On the back side, this is the back side. What is going to be bonded on the back side? Attacking nucleophile is going to be bonded on the back side. What is attacking nucleophile? That is C2H5. That is ethoxide ion. Ethoxide ion is going to be bonded from the back side, and from the front side, what is going to be removed? Bromine is going to be removed, and this state is called as transition state. Transition state. And my dear students, I am not completing this reaction. You have to complete the reaction. After this, you have to write the products. What are the products are going to be? That is your task. So finally, I am concluding that elimination reactions of haloalkanes takes place when the haloalkanes are going to react with a strong base, and nucleophilic substitution reactions of haloalkanes takes place when they are going to react with a nucleophile which is not acting as a strong base. When the nucleophile is acting as a strong base, then only elimination reactions are taking place in haloalkanes. So this is about elimination reactions versus substitution reactions in haloalkanes. Next, we are going to see reactions of haloalkanes with metals. Next, it is a reaction of metals with haloalkanes. Reaction of metals with haloalkanes. Here I am going to say the reaction of haloalkanes with the magnesium metal. What is the general formula of haloalkanes? R single bond X. That is the haloalkane general formula. When it is going to react with a reactive metal, you know, first year group elements and second year group elements are reactive metals. Here I am taking a reactive metal, that is magnesium. And the reaction is carried in presence of dry ether. Ether, here it is acting as a solvent. Now, alkyl group is going to react with magnesium and halogen to give alkyl magnesium halide. R means alkyl, Mg, that is a magnesium. X means that is halide. So what is the product obtained here? Alkyl magnesium halide is the product. Alkyl group is the organic group. Organic group. Alkyl group is the organic group. That is organo Mg is the metal. Mg is the metal that is metallic. X is the halogen, that is the halide. So simply we can say, what are obtained the products? The product obtained are organometallic halides. When haloalkanes, that is RX compounds, reacting with the magnesium metal in presence of dry ether, then we get alkyl magnesium halides, which are known as organometallic compounds. And these compounds are prepared first time by the scientist Grignard. Grignard. So the reaction is called as Grignard reaction. Grignard reaction. Most important for PU 1 marks as well as for 2 marks. Grignard reaction means reaction of haloalkanes with magnesium metal in presence of dry ether to give alkyl magnesium halides or organometallic halides is known as Grignard reaction. And this is most important reagent which is used to prepare more than million number of organic compounds. This is used to prepare more than million number of organic compounds. As a result, the scientist Grignard is awarded a Nobel Prize for the discovery of this organometallic halide, right? And the reaction is named as Grignard reaction. Right, one more. In the first PUC, you studied one reaction. Known that Wood's reaction. You know the reaction in the first PUC, organic chemistry, that is a Wood's reaction. What is Wood's reaction? Tell me. You have to answer. I'm not going to express because already in the first PUC you completed. If you don't know this one, please go through the NCERT textbook of class 11 as well as class 12. In the present topic also, at the reaction of metals topic in the textbook, you can find out the Wood's reaction. You had the answer. If you don't get answer, if you get any doubt, if you are not understood, text me. I will answer you. I will assist you. Right? And here I'm going to say some reaction, Grignard reaction. In the case of a Grignard reaction, what is the product obtained? R single bond Mg single bond X. Generally, we know that alkyl groups contain partial positive charge. But here, alkyl group is going to contain partial negative charge. Why it is going to happen? Why? Because means, in general, if I write magnesium, that is the electropositive element, you know, it is a divalent. Divalent means I can write partial delta 2 plus. And here halogen is univalent and I can write delta minus. Then here a delta 2 plus is there, delta minus is there, and it is a neutral molecule. So to neutralize the charges here on the alkyl group, what I have to write? Delta minus. It is a very important thing you have to understand. So whenever alkyl magnesium halides are given, any type of alkyl magnesium halide is given, or any organometallic compound is given, what you have to understand? That is, alkyl group is going to contain partial negative charge. Right. Now, we are going to react with water. Grignard reagent. This reagent, organometallic halide, that is also known as Grignard. Grignard reagent. Right. In the complete organic chemistry, now we are studying about haloalkanes, halogens. Next, so many topics are there. In every chapter, whenever we are going through the organic chemistry, we heard about the reactions of Grignard reagent. Just remember the Grignard reagent, the formula is R single bond Mg single bond X. Here I am going to say only one reaction of a Grignard reagent, that is reaction with water. Reaction with water. Reaction with water. When the Grignard reagent is going to react with water, that is R single bond Mg single bond X is going to react with water. Water formula, H2O. Actually, we know water as H2O, of course. Suppose if it is ionized, it gives. If it is ionized, it gives H plus ions and OH minus ions. This H plus ions of water reacts with R minus. You know that here alkyl group is having negative charge, water molecule, hydrogen is having positive charge. So alkyl group of Grignard reagent react with H plus ion of water to give alkyl group bonded with hydrogen. What is that one? Alkane. Once again, alkyl group bonded with hydrogen means alkane. So what are prepared? Alkanes are prepared by reaction of Grignard reagent with water. Whenever Grignard reagent reacts with water, that gives corresponding alkanes. Suppose here, instead of R, if I take CH3, I get CH4, methane. Instead of R, if I take C2H5, here I can get C2H6. So Grignard reagent is used to prepare alkanes starting from N value 1. That is methane, ethane, propane, butane. Any alkane can be prepared by the reaction of Grignard reagent with water, right? So this is all about haloalkanes chapter. So in the next chapter, that is haloarenes, we are going to study the preparation of haloarenes and chemical properties of haloarenes. Just a brief introduction about haloarenes. Already in the IUPAC nomenclature also, we discussed about haloalkanes as well as haloarenes, their IUPAC nomenclature. And if haloarene is taken, arene means that contain a benzene ring. Benzene ring is having alternative pi bonds. Pi bonds means electron rich center. Electron rich center means nucleophilic center. So whenever nucleophilic center is there, they are going to react with electrophiles. So just remember, haloarenes are going to show electrophilic reactions. Those electrophilic substitution reactions will be studied in the next coming videos, right? And my dear students, every day I am remembering you the same. On the 13th August, you are having the test on haloalkanes only. So up to this topic, whatever completed, the question paper is already printed. That will be posted into your WhatsApp groups. You have to answer. But whenever you are going to answer on a script, mention your name, your admission number, and other informations, that is a date, time, from when to where to where, that is from 10:30 or 11:30, whatever the time you are allotted, please mention the time. And at the end of that paper, try to make sure the signature of your parent, whether it is the signature of your mother or it is the signature of your father, the signature must be present at the top whenever you are going to start the answers. And whenever you are going to complete the answers, at the bottom also, that is signature must be needed. Because that's why only we can understand whether you are going through or not. Right? Thank you, my dear students. If you get any doubt, please call me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you and all. Have a nice day. Stay home. Stay safe.